Hello students, today we are proceeding towards the next topic of Kingdom Pratistha. So under Kingdom Pratistha, in the previous lecture we have discussed about euglenoids. General features or silent features of euglenoids we have discussed in the previous video. Now we will discuss about the last group, that is last group of the Kingdom Pratistha, that is protozoans. As the name itself indicates, protozoa. Proto means primitive. Zoa means animals. Primitive animals. Okay. So, some of the features under classification, let us discuss. First of all, these protozoans are the primitive animals. And since they are animals, they draw the nutrition from the other organisms. The mode of nutrition in such group is heterotroph. Majority of them are, I mean, almost all they are heterotrophs in their nature. And with reference to their nature, whether they are saprophyte or parasite, what they are? They are, some of them are predators and some of them are parasites. You might be knowing the meaning of predators. Predators means an animal which kills the other organism and feeds, which eats the other organism, is called as predator. And parasite is that organism which leads its life as a parasite, or it draws the nutrition from the living host. Parasites are the organisms which draw their nutrition from the living host. And such organisms are called parasites. Means protozoans, either they may be predators, means they kill the other organism and eat. And the parasites are those organisms which draw the nutrition from the living host. So, either they will be predators or they will be parasite. And as I told you in the beginning only, protozoans are primitive relatives of the animals. If you find the meaning, if you split the word protozoans, proto means primitive, zoans means animals. So, they are the primitive animals. Now, we shall move towards classification of the protozoans. Protozoans are broadly classified into four groups, but based on which criteria they are classified? So the major criteria for the classification of protozoan is that based on the presence and absence of the locomotory organ, and mainly they are classified based on the locomotory organs, whether the locomotory organs are present or absent. Based on this criteria, the protozoans are broadly classified into four categories. Number one, amoeboid. Number two, flagellated. For flagellated protozoans, ciliated protozoans, sporozoans, protozoans. We shall see some of the features of amoeboid. As the name itself indicates, amoeboid means this group includes amoeba, entamoeba. So amoeba, entamoeba, both are aquatic in their nature. So amoeba is found in water, in the water, and entamoeba, it is not found in the water, but it leads its life as a parasite in the human intestine. Entamoeba, it feeds on the human intestine. It is present in the human intestine. And majority of the amoeboid, they are found in fresh water. And very few are found in the marine water. So, fresh water, clear water, whereas marine water means salt water. The marine water contains salt water. With reference to their locomotory organs, amoeboid, this group consists of locomotory organs pseudopodia. So they possess pseudopodia. Pseudopodia means that is false foot. False foot. With the help of false foot or pseudopodia, they capture the food material and they engulf the food material. Means pseudopodia, not only they are meant for the locomotion, but they are also meant for the capturing of the food material. For both the purpose, the pseudopodia are present. So these are the most important key point. This is the key point of this group amoeboid. Next, flagellated protozoans. Again, once again, it is, as the name itself indicates, flagellated means which possess flagella. Either the number of flagella may be single or more than one. Thousands of flagella also they may possess. Let us see some of the examples coming under this group. Flagellated, this group either they live their life as a free living or parasitic. Means what? Free living means independently they live, means they are not depending on any other organism, independently they survive. But some of the flagellated organisms, protozoans, they lead their life as a parasitic. Parasite means, as beginning only I told you, parasite means which draw the nutrition from the living host. And second character, they have flagella as a locomotory organ. Apart from that, they have an opening. If you see, that is the trypanosoma is one example. The diagram is not given in the NCERT. From the reference book, we have to collect the information. See, they have a cavity. They have a body. Internally, they have a cavity. That cavity is called gullet. So, what is gullet? Gullet is a cavity that opens outside of the cell surface. So, that open outside that, which is meant for the, that is passing of the food material. Apart from that, this group also consists of trypanosoma, parasitic form. The best example is trypanosoma, having only single flagella. Trypanosoma is a single flagella, means it is a unicellular organism having single flagella, and it's a parasitic form. It's a parasite means it will draw its nutrition from the organism, I mean living organism, from the human body. And it causes a disease called sleeping sickness. So when the person suffer from the sleeping sickness, he feel very drowsy. So this is the main symptom of the sleeping sickness, which is caused by trypanosoma. Next comes ciliated. Third group is ciliated. Cilia means locomotory organs. Here instead of flagella, this group consists of flagella. Cilia. Thousands of cilia. The best example for this group is a paramecium. Unicellular organism having thousands of cilia for the locomotion. Thousands of cilia are there for the locomotion. And they are found in the water. So hence they are aquatic in their nature. Next, last groups comes, that is sporozoans. Sporozoa. Zoa, animus, sporo, that is spore-like structure. In their life cycle, they possess spore-like structure in their life cycle. Hence the name sporozoa. And these organisms are characterized by, they do not possess any motile structure like flagella, cilia or pseudopodia. They are non-motile. They do not bear any motile structure. Hence, they are known as non-motile organisms. And the best example is a malaria. Malaria is a disease which is caused by Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax, it is a protozoa, does not have any cilia or flagella, spherical structure, and it causes a disease called malaria. Okay, so malarial parasite, that is Plasmodium vivax. And this group is coming under, example coming under sporozoans of the protozoans. And as I told you, they possess in their life cycle, one stage comes, that stage is infectious stage, that is presence of a sporozoa. So the infectious stage we come across in the sporozoans, in the life cycle of the sporozoa. So with the help of sporozoan only, Plasmodium causes the disease called malaria. Okay, and it is carried by a parasite carrier, that is vector, called female Anopheles mosquito. So female Anopheles mosquito is a carrier of the Plasmodium vivax, and this is the causal organism of malaria. So these are the four major groups comes under protozoa. Okay, should stop.